Hey Bot Builders! In this video, I'm going to show you how to transcribe a voice note sent from WhatsApp using Botpress. By the end of this video, you'll know how to configure the Botpress WhatsApp integration and design a flow for transcribing and responding to those voice notes. So, let's get to it. What are your opening hours? You asked, what are your opening hours? We're open Monday to Friday from 6 a.m. to 10 p.m. and weekends from 8 a.m. to 8 p.m. Thank you so much, you made my day. So the first thing you have to do is set up a meta business profile. I did that in the last video. We'll link to it somewhere up here. And I'm not going to go through that again, largely because you can only do that once with a phone number and it's a pain in the ass. So the next thing you're going to have to do is set up an app on the Meta Developer dashboard. That's because to integrate with Botpress in such a way that you can access media that is sent through WhatsApp, you need to integrate manually using the Meta Developer dashboard. We also have a video that covers all that. I'll link to that up here too. The short of it is that you're going to go here to the Meta Developer page and you're going to want to create an app up here. And then you fill out the information. I'm not going to go through it again because I already have an app set up, and that's this one over here. Now's the part where we configure the integration in Botpress to communicate with the Meta Developer app. So I'm here in the Botpress studio. We want to look for the WhatsApp integration. Now, just for those of you who don't know, an integration is basically the tool that you connect to a bot that lets it access a third-party tool. In this case, it's WhatsApp. So I'll show you what I did here. In the Botpress studio, you hit Explore Hub, you search for WhatsApp, which as you can tell, I already did. Click it. I've already have it installed and configured. If that's not the case, you'll see a button here that says Install. You'll click it. Now you go to the Configuration tab and you will be introduced with configure using OAuth. That is the automatic configuration and it's good for most cases. However, in this case, if you want to transcribe a voice note, you're going to want to configure manually using your own Meta app. The reason you have to do manual configuration in this case is because it's the only way to access the Graph API, which is seen here. And by the way, this goes for images too. To configure this, you have to fill out all these fields. As you can see, I filled it out already, but I'll show you where to find all this information. First thing you do is you go to the dashboard for the Meta Developer app. What you're gonna wanna do here is go to WhatsApp in the left sidebar, hit configuration. So first you grab this webhook URL and you put that here in callback URL. These two match. Next thing you do here in Botpress is you come up with a verify token. You can think of that as just a password. It has to match between the two layers. So you have banana here, is what I put. And I put that here as the verify token. You can't see it. It also does this annoying thing when you click on it that the little circles go away. So it looks like it got deleted. It didn't. The next thing is the client secret. So we're going to go up here to app settings, basic. And we have the app secret over here. Copy that over. And lastly, phone number ID. You're going to go down to the sidebar in WhatsApp, hit API setup. Phone number ID. It's right here. Paste that in. Last thing we have here is the access token. I saved that for last. An access token you generate over here in the same place. WhatsApp API setup. You hit generate. Now copy it. Once you hit generate, while you can still see it, because once you're done with it, you cannot see it again. So I already have one generated. I've already copied it. And I put that here in access token. Now I'm going to show you how to transcribe the audio file that's sent through WhatsApp. The first thing you're going to have to do is in bot settings here, you want to create an environment variable, WhatsApp access token. I mean, you can name it whatever. This is what I'm calling it. If you want to follow along, you can do the same. And you're going to paste the same access token from the last step. This is why you need to copy it. Now, if you forget what it is or you can't find it, remember, you already have it configured in your WhatsApp integration right here. So here, I'm in the Botpress studio. We're going to create a standard node. Now, mind you, I already built this. It's off to the side. So the first thing you're going to do basically is there's some boilerplate code. Ultimately, what it does is it fetches the file from the Graph API from WhatsApp and it stores it in the Botpress files API and returns the URL to be able to access that file. So I'm going to copy all this code. Basically, I'll leave you a gist in GitHub and I'm going to give you an execute code card here. So a couple things in the code. First of all, the token that you're going to need in order to access the Graph API is your WhatsApp access token. Other than that, the only things that you're going to have to configure yourself is workflow.uploaded URL. You're going to want to create that variable yourself. That's over here. Basically, what this does is it finds the URL that WhatsApp passes that contains the audio. Now, we can't access that audio directly, so we have to use the Graph API here, fetch Facebook data. That is fetching the data from the Facebook Graph API. And we download the file and then we upload it to the Botpress files API because that makes it accessible through Botpress. Finally, we save that URL to the files API in workflow.uploaded URL, which is this variable here. And when you create a new variable, if you want to create it again, make sure it's in the workflow scope. You go uploaded URL. Obviously, you can call it whatever you want. You just have to make sure it matches in the execute code card. Now that net name's already in use, obviously, because we have one over here. So I'm not going to do that. So we want to add a card to transcribe it. We add a transcribe audio card. So the ID here is the ID of the model. We're going to be using OpenAI's Whisper 1 model. And the file URL is going to be held in workflow dot, say it with me, uploaded URL. Cool. Now it's going to output a transcription. So we want to save that transcription to another variable. In this case, it's going to be workflow dot transcription. So it transcribes the audio. It outputs basically a string. How do we do stuff with that string? For now, just as kind of a sanity check, going to return the transcription of what the user said back to the user. So that's going to be workflow.transcription. Now it gets added as an object. To access that object, you have to go into a couple of sub layers here. So segments is an array, you get the first one, and the text key is what holds the whole transcript. And then we connect it. This is going to be a very simple flow that just transcribes the audio and sends it back to the user. Again, just a sanity check. I'm going to hit deploy to deploy it. This won't work unless you hit publish, by the way. Now let's try it out. Cool. Okay, let's send a message. How many turtles can you fit in a bathtub? All right. Little disclaimer, here at Botpress, we often have to test out WhatsApp chatbots, and it is a pain in the ass to get a business profile approval for a WhatsApp chatbot, which means we basically all share the same phone number to do this. Now, different people hook up different chatbots to that phone number, and so I'm getting responses from both the chatbot that I just built and showed you, and also someone else's chatbot that clearly doesn't have the ability to transcribe audio files. So please ignore this first one over here. The second one, though, I think we agree, is a transcription of the message I sent. So it works, basically, which is lovely. Obviously, this flow is not incredibly helpful because all it does is send back the information to the user. Now, if you'll remember from the last video, what this chatbot is supposed to do, let me bring you back the flow from earlier, is answer FAQ questions and policy questions about a hypothetical gym called Fitness Zone. The instructions are over here. It basically has access to a bunch of FAQs that are in my knowledge base. Let's pull that up. Here, Fitness Zone, opening hours, FAQ. So if I can say things like, what are your opening hours? Okay, great. The whole point of this tutorial was to be able to also transcribe and respond to voice messages. So how do we do that in the context of a bot that answers questions and stuff? What I did over here is I created a separate flow called Transcribe Audio. Let's check out that flow over here. So this has the exact same card that I showed you before, all the exact same code. We have the workflow uploaded URL. Oh my God, no, I don't actually have that. So I actually have to create that. Uploaded URL. Cool. So this will store the files API, URL to uploaded URL. Now we're going to extract it from uploaded URL. Cool, that's all set up. We save it in transcription. Now what this does is it grabs a transcription, if it exists. It saves that to a conversation variable. I'll talk about that in a second. And it also logs it to the console, which means if you want to check your logs for your conversations later, it'll show up there, which is, in my opinion, a very good idea. So once it's done that, it exits. And in my instructions, I added a header for audio files. So if the user submits an audio file, move to the transcription workflow to transcribe the file. The transcription will be held in conversation.transcription. That's true. The point of having a conversation variable, a variable with the conversation scope, is that it's accessible by all flows within the conversation. And then it resets in a new conversation, which is kind of exactly what you want when it comes to a transcript that might be accessed by different flows. So that variable, as you know, is set in the transcribe audio flow. And then it is accessed back in the main flow. Return the transcription to the user in a conversational manner and respond to the transcribe message. Because when you send a message, you want to make sure that the bot has acknowledged that it understands what you said. You don't necessarily want to do this, and we can try deleting that later, but it'll both return to you what you said. So it's like, hey, you asked about our opening hours. And then it'll say something like, we're open from Monday to Friday, 8 to 6 or whatever. Let's publish this bot and see if it works. What are your opening hours? Okay, cool. Again, ignore. You know what? In fact, gone forever. Okay, you asked, what are your opening hours? We're open Monday to Friday from 6 a.m. to 10 p.m. and weekends from 8 a.m. to 8 p.m. Cool. What classes do you offer? Hey, cool. You asked, what classes do you offer? Same thing. We offer a variety of classes, including yoga, Pilates, spin. Sweet. This makes me very happy. This is very cool. Thank you so much. You made my day. This one was just for fun. I'm glad to hear that. Is there anything else I can assist you with? Well, I'm going to leave you hanging for now. So that's it. That's how you transcribe an audio file sent to a WhatsApp chatbot using Botpress. I hope you enjoyed, and let me know in the comments what you'd like to see next. Until then, happy bot building.